On this episode of On the Record, I'm joined by former Attorney General and Senior Advocate Mukul Rohatgi. The reason why we're speaking to Mr. Rohatgi is because he was not just the former top law officer of the country, but he was also very close to former Union Minister, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, and really gives us insight about the passing of Arun Jaitley and why he mattered so much to Indian politics. Thank you, Mr. Rohatgi, for speaking to Hindustan Times. I want to start off by asking you that one of the things we wrote about in the paper was the fact that you were part of the Lodhi Garden Club. Can you tell our viewers what that is?
See, the Lodhi Garden Club came much later. Let's start from the beginning. In those days, he didn't have a car. And one secret I must tell you is he never learned how to drive.
He doesn't know how to drive?
No, he never knew. He never learned.
Okay.
Because he thought he's pretty forgetful at times, which he is. And so he decided not to drive. So before we got married, more or less at the same time, and when we would meet in the evenings, I would drop him either at IIT or at Dholakua. And he would then take a three-wheeler and go to his house in Naraina till he bought his first car, which was in the 80s. One incident which I remember, after about 10 years, the VP Singh government was going to appoint him as an additional Solicitor General in the Supreme Court. He was not a senior advocate. The general tradition is that an additional Solicitor General is a senior advocate. Not required by law, but that's kind of the tradition. And Jaitley was pretty young then. I mean, he was not even 40, maybe 35, 37, 38. So he spoke to me, can anything be done within one day? I told him it's not possible, but he said, why don't you speak to a judge or two? So there used to be a group of a few senior judges in the High Court who used to have paan after their meal. So I went to them at lunchtime and I requested them that, look, one of our local lawyers is going to be an ASG maybe tomorrow or day after. It's a matter of great pride for our High Court that one of us will be represented there. So could you consider designating him? The High Court, I must say, responded very quickly. They passed a resolution, a full court resolution has to be passed.
To be made into a high court.
Yes,
senior.
To be made into a senior, a full court resolution. I met them at 1:30 and by 4 o'clock, the resolution was in our hand. And at night, he went to meet Mr. VP Singh. I remember it was a winter day. Mr. Karanjwal and I were together with him. We waited in Claridge's hotel. He went to meet VP Singh. VP Singh appointed him and next day he was appointed. So that's one very, very clear incident which I remember. And then progressively, he became more and more important, more and more busy. One ministry, two ministries, three ministries, all that went on. But he always had time for his friends. And finally, he started coming to Lodhi Garden. And we also started going to Lodhi. So there's a place there where we would sit after the walk and have a cup of tea and a biscuit. We would spend about half an hour, 45 minutes before each one of us would leave for our own vocations, you know. And then after he became defense minister, finance minister and so on and so forth, his security was tightened and he was advised not to walk in the garden. So once in a while, I would go to his house, say every Sunday in the morning, walk with him in the gardens there and renew our tea and biscuit with him there. But I must tell you, our point is still there in Lodhi Garden. It is called the Lodhi Point, Jaitley Point.
Really?
Yes, everybody in Lodhi Gardens knows what is Jaitley Point.
There is a Jaitley Point.
Yes, it's just a point where we have been sitting there every morning at about 8:15, 8:30. For the last maybe 10 years or 12 years. And when Jaitley stopped coming because of either security or ill health, as it was. So on 28th of December, which is his birthday, we would always arrange, one of us in the group would arrange for a breakfast and a cake and have something to eat.
That's lovely.
And that is what we kind of carried on till the last but one birthday. And so that's the epilogue and the prologue of the Lodhi point.
So can I ask you about some behind the scenes of some major decisions, which maybe because you were the top law officer at that time as well, you can share with us?
I must also confess that Mr. Jaitley had much to do with my being appointed as the Attorney General.
Really?
Yes.
How? Tell us the story.
Well, I don't know the story, but I mean, I have no doubt. He was the eyes and ears of the Prime Minister in 2014. And he had something to do with these legal posts, appointment of judges, which lawyer should become a judge. He had been the law minister. He knew how this system works very well. And I'm sure he must have put in, he never said that to me.
He never said it.
He never said that, but I know for a fact.
So he was also one of the first people who took a very liberal position and then changed the government's position on 377.
I wanted to tell you
that.
The first important case was the National Judicial Accountability case, NJAC.
Yes, sir.
Now, even though he was not the law minister, he was the person who was strategizing for the government. When I had to speak to somebody in the government or take any counsel, I would go only to him. And mind you, and I'm sharing with you, once in a while there were other issues, legal issues, where I met the highest, including the Prime Minister. And I would normally get a stock answer. Arunji se puch lijiye.
I see. Jaisa even though he was not the law minister.
Even though he was not the law minister, Arunji se puch lijiye. And then, you know, we can take a call. He will give you a proper
answer. He was the go-to for the government.
He was the go-to for the government in all matters touching law or legalities. Of that, there was no doubt. So, NJAC was one case. Then you asked me about 377. You see, in 377, was a tricky issue. There were conservatives in the government, there are liberals in the government, as you have in the society.
Yeah.
So it was decided that the government will not put up a very strident stand one way or the other. So I told Arun that I will be appearing for this. And he himself was, you see, in favor of removing 377 because it showed a very retarded kind of a position for India, and that is how it ended. So, sometimes government's cases or viewpoints are not based solely on law. It is law, its impact.
And politics.
Politics, social impacts, how people will perceive, perception. So, he had such a mature and an incisive mind that he would put everything together.
Yes.
You know, like a ready-made meal. Put everything together and then come to the conclusion in a matter of minutes.
Yeah.
Matter of minutes.
Well, thank you so much for giving us perspective.
Thank you.
Thank you.